Folks, it's Bob Tuscan live at the Ocala, Florida Trump rally. Donald Trump is just about to speak. We are sure that he's going to be talking about the Federal Reserve today. We're pretty positive he will mention Building 7 at some point. He'll mention the fact that the ISIS videos have all been staged, and he is guaranteed to mention D's Nuts 2016. Let's see if we can get some interviews going. This guy right here. This guy right here. Who wants to talk? Come on up.
That dude right there.
This guy?
What's up, Blake?
How are you, sir?
What's happening?
Big Trump day, huh?
Oh, awesome, man. We're here with a lot of people. Can't even get in. There's so many people.
It's amazing, man. People are really starting to come out against the status quo for once.
Exactly. That's what we're all about. A vote for him is a non-vote for Hillary.
Can't have that.
Can't have that. Not in America. We got to change this thing.
Yeah, man, absolutely. How do you feel about Building 7 being one of his big campaign platforms?
Building 7?
Yeah, Building 7.
I don't know much about that.
It was the third building that fell on 9/11, the 47-story building that was just standing there and fell down in free fall speed.
Well, I know that there was some paint. I remember seeing there was a painting. They found explosives and some painting in the rubble. I assume that's the building you're talking about.
Yeah, no, it just came down free fall speed. It was sitting there, and out of nowhere, the building fell.
My ex-wife worked in the Verizon building. They heard that before anything was even hit.
Amazing, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
So do you think so?
I think so, yeah.
Right. Well, thanks, man.
We lost all of our freedoms that day.
Yeah.
Right.
Great, thank you for your time. Yeah. So people are beginning to ask questions about what's really happening. Let's continue to interview people here on the spot. Continue. Folks, we are interviewing some very interesting people here. A lot of people are actually, the first guy we interviewed is on board with the fact that Building 7 is a massive cover-up, to say the least. So let's get in front of people. Yeah, let's talk to this young lady. Go ahead. What's up? How are you?
Hi.
I'm with Gainesville News. My name's Bob Tuscan. How are you doing?
Not.
So she saw my shirt. It says taxation is theft. Pretty simple. So let me ask you something. If I was to come to your house with a gun and demand that you give me your money, or otherwise I'll shoot you or put you in a cage, would you consider that theft, force? What would you consider that?
Yeah, that's theft.
That's theft.
Yeah. So when the IRS comes and they say you have to pay your taxes or we'll shoot you or put you in a cage, how do you feel about that? Is that theft?
No, it's going towards credible things.
Like roads?
Yeah.
Like roads, healthcare, education, veterans affairs, things like that.
So if I was to come to your house with a gun and say, hey, give me your money or else I'll put you in a cage or shoot you, but don't worry, your money's going to be going to healthcare, education, then it's okay, right?
See, I wouldn't believe you, but the fact that that is what it's going for, it's a
really?
Common fact.
I'm sorry, go ahead, what's that?
Common Core's a good thing?
Is Common Core a good thing?
The fuck does that have to do with taxation?
Well, you said it's going towards education, so they're forcing us to put...
Infrastructure, have you seen our roads? Have you looked at St. Augustine right now? Do you think we don't need to fix that?
Yeah.
Do I think we don't need to fix the roads? Absolutely. So this has started all sorts of a debate. We got people from all ends of the spectrum surrounding us now. We got people who understand the idea that taxation is theft, and we have these two young ladies eloquently presenting their perspective, righteously so.
And have to pay a $7,000 deductible. Let me tell you something. The education has failed. Democrats, has your life been better in 8 years? Has anything gotten better? Highest unemployment. Highest in welfare.
All right, let's let her respond. Has anything gotten better?
Yes. Under the Obama administration, actually unemployment has decreased. He has created 9.3 million jobs. He's ended two wars.
94 million people out of the workforce. 1,000 people letting every day in for immigration. 73% of IT information technology jobs since Obama administration has gone to immigration. What about us, the American people, taking care of them? You ever hear the old
saying?
All right, so there you go, folks. Taxation is theft, but we have two sides of the argument surrounding us, literally talking about this. Yes, sir.
Yeah, back to her argument there that all the jobs that supposedly Mr. Obama created, what are those jobs? Those are not career-orientated jobs, well-paying jobs. Those are service-orientated jobs that pay minimum wage.
Dead-end jobs.
That's exactly right.
How do you feel about Trump running on the platform that Building 7 needs further investigation?
The what now?
Building 7.
Go to Common
I'm not familiar with that.
That was the third building that fell on September 11th. Wasn't hit by an airplane that they blew up in free fall speed?
I don't know. I'm into looking forward what we can do to this country now. I'm not going back on any conspiracy theories or anything like that. That's we're talking about what's going on here right now in this country now and what we need to do now.
Absolutely. So Trump talks about ISIS being a major threat. The Pentagon just came out and said that they staged a lot of those videos. It seems to me like a lot of the propaganda about ISIS is just that.
Well, that's exactly right. I think you can call it that, a bunch of propaganda that is coming from Mr. Obama to make it look like ISIS is not what it is.
Right, so he's staging these events to make ISIS look like they're not what they are.
Look, at Obama left ships out in the ocean that run bombing sorties. They just sat there. They didn't get permission to drop any bombs or anything because he doesn't want to hurt any innocent people, which I can understand. We don't want to hurt innocent people either. But this is our country here, okay? We're fighting for what we believe in here, okay? Those are casualties that happen. There's nothing we can do about that. We stop those people. If we don't stop them, they're going to be here stopping us.
Absolutely. All right, so there you go. We need proactive geopolitical wars to stop them from coming after us. This, of course, only increases their motivation to hate us if they didn't already to begin with. More drone strikes than ever before with the Obama administration. Obviously, a pro-war candidate, obviously doing everything that we thought he would not do, and I shouldn't use the word we. But, yeah.
I don't want to interrupt you, but I don't appreciate what you're spewing there because don't take my words out of context, okay?
Right.
All right?
Okay.
We can go over there and defeat those people without spilling one drop of blood, all right? It's very easy.
How do we do that?
We take all these pork producers that we got and get the pork blood that we have, and we put it in aerial sprayers, and we send it over there, and then we get fighter planes to back us up, and we just start spraying the people.
This is one of the greatest ideas I think I have ever heard, ladies and gentlemen. We need to take pig blood, swine blood, spray it on those people, and that will deter them from fucking with the USA.
That will stop them in their traps from worshiping Allah.
Stop them in their traps from worshiping Allah, ladies and gentlemen. Bob Tuscan reporting live from the Trump rally. Let's continue these absolutely insightful talks with people. I can't even keep a fucking straight face. Let's go ahead and spin the wheel here. Do you mind if we spin your wheel for a second? So the wheel of shame is what they're calling it for Hillary. Let's see what we get here. All right. Pay to play. Tell us about pay to play, will you? Pay to play. Tell me a little bit about that.
I don't know anything about it.
This isn't yours? No? Okay, great.
It's in the shade.
I don't blame you. It's a hot, not so hot day. Pay to play. What is that about? I don't know. I feel like I'm Gary Johnson all of a sudden. All right, folks, we are now live with the man himself, Donald. Donald, how are you today?
Very good. Popping along.
Great to see you. First question is Building 7. Your thoughts on Building 7?
Building 7?
Yeah, Building 7.
Can we talk about Building 5 instead? I don't know anything about Building 7.
Donald doesn't know about Building 7. Well, that's shocking, Donald. First off, I want to tell you that of all the things you need to grab by the pussy, it's the Building 7 issue. It really is.
Oh, really? Yeah. Okay, yeah. Very good. Tell me, have you ever said anything like that in your life?
I have.
Yeah. What Donald said? Did you ever say that?
I have. Locker room.
Yeah, exactly. Everybody has.
Everyone has. Right.
Politicians in D.C., they do it every day. They all got girlfriends up there.
They got, not girlfriends, they call those escorts.
They're escorts and mistresses.
Yeah, what about the pedophile rings in Washington?
Well, the pedophiles are usually with the Democrats.
With the Democrats?
Yeah.
Right, so it's a bipartisan pedophilia thing.
No. When you're talking pedophilia, you're talking Democrats. We don't have that on the Republicans.
So Democrats and pedophilia are synonymous.
Yeah, they're a group.
Right.
But who do pedophilias vote for?
For Democrats.
Exactly.
Obviously.
Right.
So, yeah, I mean, talking in locker room talk, I got my boy Donald here. We're having some locker room talk. I like my women like I like Building 7.
I don't know about...
They go down in free... Hold on. That's when I get the punchline in. They go down on me in free fall speed. 7 seconds.
Donald Trump, I practice natural law. I go after women.
Natural law? Do you know about Mark Passio? Do you know Mark Passio?
Barney Frank's on Wall Street with all young men. I'm Donald Trump. I love women. Natural law.
Natural law.
Natural law, yeah.
This is great. Of course, Mark Passio, what on earth is happening? Natural law.
Have you checked Barney Frank lately?
Barney Frank?
With all his young boyfriends on Wall Street.
I think it's pitiful, man.
Yeah, he's getting married on Wall Street.
Obama with a young boy.
To his wedding.
He didn't?
No, not at all. See, I'm like Donald. I like women. I'm Donald Trump. I like women.
You like women.
Natural law.
God heterosexual.
Adam and Eve. He didn't make Adam and Adam.
Adam and Eve, not Adam and Adam. There you go, folks. You've heard it. Donald Trump. 2016. Donald, thank you so much for talking with us.
Pardon me?
Thank you for talking with us.
Anytime. We'll see you again.
Donald, man, good to see you, Donald.
Okay.
I definitely will vote for D's, but you're a close second.
Well, if you're a Dem, you can hang around with all the pedophiles on Wall Street.
No, I'm not a Democrat. No, I'm voting for D's.
Okay, good. You work for who?
D's.
You work for D's?
Yeah, D's nuts. Okay. Thanks, Donald. All right, there you go, folks. Donald Trump, you've heard it. The Democrats are pedophiles. Locker room talk, Building 7, of course, a big thing. How do you feel about Building 7? We got a New York Yankees hat over there. Building 7 guy right there. Let's continue. That's absolutely insightful.
I'm taking the glasses off. It's annoying. Although they kind of help the camera
fly. Yeah.
Sure, absolutely.
Here, let me see your... Put them on.
I didn't say got him in enough time.
Oh, okay. Now we're doing selfies here.
That's right.
That's all right. We got to do something.
Favorite thing that's happened so far. I'm only here to.
All right. Favorite thing that's happened. There you go. Got the taxation is theft and all. We're doing selfies with the people. This is a real politician. Let's get back to the thick of things here. Let's go over to this little corner here. Get this Trump stuff in the background. Get the sign. Hillary is a witch. Just in time for Halloween, is Hillary an actual witch?
Hillary is a witch and CNN is her broom.
Have you heard the conspiracies that she's a reptilian?
Haven't heard that one yet.
Have you heard the fact that Hillary is one of the Bilderberg members?
All I can say is remember Benghazi, remember Libya. Hillary is a witch. She wants to control everything and be a globalist. We want America to have a future. Hillary is a witch and CNN is her broom.
What about Building 7? How do you feel about Building 7?
I'm holding my sign.
She's holding her sign, Building 7. And the Federal Reserve?
My statement is Hillary is a witch and CNN is her broom.
Hillary's a witch. Hillary is a criminal. Let's talk to this gentleman.
By a rope from downtown D.C.
Okay.
If they try to install her, she's a criminal and she should not be allowed to run for president.
Well,
Sons of Liberty, National Council. That's us.
She will be selected, though, right?
Well, you know something. She's a criminal. And criminals don't get allowed to run for POTUS.
Yeah.
She's going to hang by the neck until dead in downtown D.C. if she's installed.
How do you feel about Building 7?
Building 7?
Yeah.
Was dropped internally.
Yeah.
Wasn't it?
Yeah, what?
Yes, it was, by Bush and company.
Right.
And George Soros and David Rockefeller. Yeah. And the Rothschild family in Europe. Our fiat currency holders. It's time to take our country back, ladies and gentlemen.
Bitcoin to the world.
Let's talk Bitcoin here.
Bitcoin,
come on, up here. We got a Bitcoin representative. Let's talk about cryptocurrency.
Fuck fiat, Bitcoin to the world.
Is taxation theft?
Without representation, brother, yes it is.
And cryptocurrencies, are they better than the fractional reserve banking system?
Yes, they are.
Why?
That's too deep a conversation to have, right?
I'm pretty deep, dude.
I'm done.
Pretty deep. All right, cryptocurrency. Let's get an interview with this gentleman here, sir. Secret Service?
Hillary,
no comment.
No comment. Yeah, he's got no comment. Let's talk to this man. Let's talk about this guy, Freebird Leonard Skinner.
Yeah. How you doing?
If you're watching karaoke, what's your number one request?
That's Mel. No. Hillary will go to prison. Again, these people are mad.
This guy's still screaming over here.
It's part of the Clinton Foundation. James Comey committed treason, and he will hang by the neck until dead. Sons of Liberty National Council, Jack Powers is here today in person to announce to you that Hillary Clinton will hang by the throat until dead.
Jack, do you know Bob Tuscan?
Yes, I do. Sons of Liberty National Council.
Your thoughts on Bob Tuscan?
We are the historians.
Your thoughts on Bob Tuscan?
I'll hold my thoughts on Bob. I'm going to hold my thoughts on Bob.
Why is that? Anything about Bob Tuscan in particular?
I'm talking about James Comey right now. And the next one I'm going to talk about is Loretta Lynch.
Oh.
Loretta Lynch got Bill and Hillary out of Whitewater. Loretta Lynch has committed treason. She is not an attorney general. She is foe. Loretta Lynch is foe.
Do you want to know who I'm voting for?
F-A-U-X. Just like Faux News or Fox News and Megan Smelly, the queen of Babylon, ISIS, Megan Smelly. She's going to hang too. We are going to take this all the way to D.C.
Do you know this man?
We have operatives in D.C. and they have laid siege.
It's good to know that people are active here at the Trump rally.
Sons of Liberty National Council.
Sons of Liberty National Council. One more thing, Bob Tuscan.
I told you I would reserve myself on Bob Tuscan. I'm calling the shots, not you.
Bob Tuscan?
I'm calling the shots, not you.
Okay, he's going to reserve himself.
Loretta Lynch will hang by the throat until dead. She is not an attorney general. She is foe.
All right, folks, this is a very heated debate going on. He has no comment on Bob Tuscan. Building 7 fell in free fall speed. Let's continue our interviews here. Let's see here. This is a very exciting day, folks, where a lot of passions are flying. That's definitely the case. Let's see if we can interview another person here. How do you feel about all this?
It's every bit of the circus I hoped it would be.
And Building 7, where do you think this fits in with the whole circus?
I'm pretty sure that fell down, what, 15 years ago?
Free fall speed?
Evidently.
Not hit by an airplane?
So I hear.
Awesome. All right. Thank you for your time. There you go, folks. People have heard of Building 7 at the Trump rally. In fact, in the anecdotal experience thus far, we have heard from more people that know about Building 7 than at all of our previous Building 7 challenges combined. Let's continue to meet with some zealots here at the Trump rally. We've got a lot of entrepreneurs at the event selling t-shirts. Let's see. All right, so I'm hearing some banter about Trump assaulting women, and I just got to tell you, Hillary Clinton and Bill Clinton are behind crimes, not just indiscretions of infidelity, but actual crimes where they've murdered, raped, killed, that's the same as murder, many people. So why is it on both sides of the spectrum we've seen a divide take place when we know that both candidates are very much involved with the same crimes? Your thoughts on Building 7, sir?
On what?
Building 7.
I have no idea what Building 7 is.
It was the third building that fell on 9/11 that was not hit by an airplane.
Why is that important today?
You didn't hear about Donald Trump being on board with exposing what happened with Building 7?
Conspiracy theory, yeah.
I don't know anything about it, never heard of it.
You should check out the footage of Building 7 when you get a chance. It might be interesting for you to see.
Might not.
Might not? All right, let's see here.
She said they were lying. There were all kinds of things. Don't say she didn't do anything. No, he didn't. You guys keep saying Trump. Okay, listen. Just hush and listen. Listen. Everybody wants to say.
Listen.
No. Okay. All four of you can go against me if that makes you feel good.
Sir, I have a question. Do you need some oxygen?
Yes, I do. I need a lot of oxygen because this lady's sucking it all up right now.
How do you feel about Building 7?
I would really like to hear
who.
What you say.
Building 7.
Building 7 of World Trade.
Yeah.
I couldn't care less.
Mexicans are.
And is taxation theft?
Okay.
Is it theft? Yeah, for me it is, because they're taking all the money I need to raise my two kids by myself. So,
do you
pay taxes? Because I get earned income, so I get all that back. So I don't pay taxes.
Do unicorn lives matter?
I'm taking the system for what it is, just like Trump did. He didn't pay taxes. I don't pay taxes either, because I get child earned income credit, so I get all that money back. Does that make me less American?
Excuse me. Do unicorn lives matter, sir?
Yes, exactly.
Clown lives, they count?
Not so much.
What about Jewish reptilians? Are they on the docket?
They're okay. They're okay. Exactly. They take care of the insects.
Exactly. Jewish reptilians?
Yeah.
How do you feel about the USS Liberty, sir?
The USS, what is that? Is that a dirigible?
The real thing. So like
what?
A dirigible. Okay. A blimp.
No, the USS Liberty, the naval ship that was attacked by Israel?
I don't know nothing about it.
Well,
how could I have a feeling on it if I don't know anything about it?
The Iran-Contra scandal, how do you feel about the military smuggling drugs?
That's that one game. Contra? That's another.
No, the Iran-Contra scandals where Oliver North and his cronies in the U.S. military were involved with trafficking drugs and then selling it to folks like Freeway Ricky Ross.
Grandfather. All that. Oliver North, he has a chicken joint, doesn't he?
Property, right?
No. He's a colonel in the military.
Well, then he has chicken.
Like Colonel Sanders?
Exactly.
Yes, go ahead. Cool. All right, let's continue to get some takes. Sir, Building 7, your thoughts?
I'm not talking.
No comment? Okay.
No comment.
Oh, you're watching out for her? Do you think that these crazy liberals are at any given time liable to come after her, physically assault her?
I just want to know why they're here. That's all I want to know.
Well, would you? What am I?
What are you doing here?
I'm here to cover the news. I'm a neutral third party.
Now.
How do you feel about that?
Saying that passing down wealth to your children doesn't affect the future?
No, you said
that's
that
what I just said.
Sir, I hate to interrupt this, but
what is that about to do with
is taxation theft?
You're literally wasting your breath.
I know. I'm sorry.
Is taxation theft?
No, taxation is not theft.
If I come to your house with a gun and tell you, hey, give me your money or else I'll put you in a cage, is that theft?
Yes.
If the IRS comes to your house and says, give me your money or I'll put you on the in a cage, is that theft?
How did you get here today?
The roads.
Who paid for the roads?
We did, the tax money. Without tax money, we would never have roads, right?
Right.
So taxation's not theft because roads?
Well, because roads, because
schools.
Schools? What did you learn in school?
I learned how to be successful, and it gives me an opportunity to be what I want, which is most important.
Do you know what you want to be?
Yes, sir.
What's that?
I want to be a welder.
A welder?
Yes, sir.
And you learned that in school?
No.
There you go. The school gave him the skills to learn to be what he wants to be. He wants to be a welder, but he didn't learn that in school. There you go.
Hey, I want to finish though, okay? I can read, and I come from a lower class family, and if it was up to them to pay for it, I wouldn't have an education here. I wouldn't be able to talk to you. I wouldn't be able to drive. I wouldn't be able to count. I wouldn't be able to do shit.
So I think it would be only smart then to rob him so that I can help you read, right?
Sort of, yeah.
Yes, on a memory.
Okay, go on.
I'm just making sure I wrap my head around it. So, in order so that you can read, which I want you to read, dude, it's important to be literate, but I definitely think I should steal from you so that I can help him read. How do you feel about that?
Oh, okay, I see. No, I know.
I think that there's been a long history of white people stealing from black people to help white children read. But please continue. My point is that
so it's a racial thing.
No.
What point are you trying to make with all of this? I'm very interested. Please enlighten me.
Well, I'm here today on the Building 7 platform. Are you familiar with Building 7?
I'm not.
Okay, it's the third building that fell on 9/11 at free fall speed. Wasn't hit by an airplane.
Right. We can do that. That's not the point. The point is that if you listen to what he says, she wants to. I know what you stand against. What do you stand for?
At this point, equal rights. People's points to actually say what they want.
For black people, for women, for minorities.
We all have equal rights.
Oh, honey, I'm sorry.
Secret Service?
No.
Is it racist to think that a black guy looking as sharp as you do, man, and you look good as hell, is with the Secret Service on a day like today?
Well, the reason I did this is because of the stereotype that most people get. So I'm a pastor. But I've walked around for maybe 5-10 minutes, and they think I work for the government. So the stereotype.
Yeah.
So the fact that a guy makes a comment and makes a mistake 5-6 years ago, and then he's penalized for it now. I think that tactfully he could have said some things differently and maybe confessed, like say, hey, look, you know, that was me 5 years ago. You know, I said it, you know, and you know, that was me. But now I'm at this place now where I'm trying to move my country forward. So I think his writer needs some help, the one who prepares his speeches. But like the little guy that was here a few minutes ago, ranting and raving, we're dying out here. We've been dying out here. That's not a real issue. People got to get to the real issues at hand. And sure, you know, sure, Black Lives Matter, but you all lives matter too. So
that's racist, sir.
Black Lives Matter?
No. All lives matter.
All lives matter? No, I don't think that's racist.
Yes, it is.
I think the fact is when people say all lives matter, you know, that's a statement that all lives do matter. You know, whether
excuse me for just a second. We're getting some craziness going on. Folks seem to think that they can push people with dissenting opinions out of the proximity here. I believe these people have every right to be here. As you have a right to be here, you guys are absolutely misguided because both sides are brainwashed. Yeah, let's give it up for D's Nuts 2016. No one? No one?
I'm not voting.
Well, that was a fail. That was a fail. Anyways, let's continue. We're trying to get people behind the fact that both sides of the equation are brainwashed, but it's not working here. This is a very bipartisan event, and as a result, this is a very brainwashed event, but let's continue. Sir, how do you feel about Building 7 being the main issue the Trump campaign's taking on this time around?
The what?
Building 7.
What's Building 7? I don't know what you're talking about.
The third building that fell in free fall speed on 9/11.
What? He did a great job trying to keep it great, didn't you think so?
Yeah, no, absolutely.
Yeah. I mean, Trump, you know, if Trump doesn't get elected, if Hillary gets in there, the veterans in this country, and I'm one of them, will be dead. It will absolutely kill the veterans.
They're going to round them up and kill them all, or?
No, they're just not going to be able to get the health care like they can't get now.
Right.
Yeah. So, you know, and not only that, but you're right there, because she's going to raise everybody's taxes.
And taxation step.
Exactly.
Now, if I come to your house and try to steal from you and say, hey, I'm putting it towards the roads, yeah, would that be considered IRS protocol?
No, Steph.
Steph.
This is what the IRS does.
Right.
Yeah.
All right, there you go, folks. IRS is theft. Taxation is theft. Let's continue to see if we can get some bipartisan perspectives.
What is it here? What are you guys doing?
We're here to interview people about one of the biggest campaign platforms that Donald Trump has yet to announce, and that is the Building 7 campaign.
Okay.
You're familiar with Building 7?
No.
Okay. Would you vote for somebody who wanted to expose what really happened with Building 7?
Tell me exactly what Building 7 is.
Building 7 was the third building that fell in free fall speed on 9/11, was not hit by an airplane, came down 5:20 in the afternoon or so in 6 seconds.
Oh, okay.
Your thoughts?
I've never heard of it, so it's interesting.
What's that?
Are you creating?
Building 7.
I don't believe it exists. I have no idea what you're talking about. It sounds insane to me.
It doesn't exist. It's just it's media.
Yeah, I guess it's been hidden for all these years since 2011.
There you go, folks. Since 2011, Building 7 has been hidden. You're absolutely right, sir. Thank you. I couldn't even keep a straight face with that one. That was cringeworthy. That's going to make the final cut, definitely. Mark my words, ladies and gentlemen. Here we are, folks, at the Trump campaign rally in Ocala, Florida. Let's see if we can get some insight. Sir, how do you feel under here?
Yeah.
What? How do you feel?
I'm hot.
You're hot?
Hot.
Do you feel like a Mexican right now trying to smuggle into the country?
Don't get me involved in that. Go ahead.
Yeah.
No, don't get me involved.
Orale, bato.
No hable.
No hable ingles?
No hable ingles.
Okay, well, there you go, folks. We're interviewing a real-life Mexican at the Trump rally. Is the wall going to deter you from getting over?
Everything did. It's ridiculous.
Gracias, mi chavo.
De nada.
There you go, folks. Real-life Mexican smuggling into the Trump event live. Uh-oh, we got photography happening here. Is photography a crime? No comment. Okay. There you go. I think photography ought to be a crime, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see if we can interview any more Mexicans down here.
You know that's fun.
Hey, how are you, sir?
Good.
Make America great again?
You bet.
All right. Here we go. You know, you don't even have to say anything to people, and you just say, make America great again, and it's kind of like a gang sign, for crying out loud. They say, oh, yeah, he's part of the club. All right, here we go. I think we have another live one here. How are you, ma'am?
I'm great. Trump's great.
Trump's great.
You got it.
Wait, let me ask you something, and I don't mean to be disrespectful, but if you, you know, if you were younger, would you let, you know, maybe in the locker room or whatever, would you let him grab you by the pussy?
You know, that's guy talk.
Guy talk.
It's guy talk.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Trump is coming up here. Hold on. Rudolph Giuliani! Hold on here. Come on, Eddie. Come on here. Watch out here. Excuse me, media. Rudolph Giuliani? Is that him? Yep. All right, let's go talk to Rudolph. My good buddy Rudolph Giuliani is here. For those of you who hadn't watched my former encounters with Giuliani, he told me to get a haircut. I got a haircut, and now he is live at the Trump rally, making America great again. Of course, he was behind the cover-up of 9/11. We love him for that. We love anybody who can cover up something as colossal as 9/11. This is very serious. Who just came on?
Giuliani.
And what was he famous for?
Hey man, I'm trying to listen to this.
What's that, ma'am?
Come on, dude.
What was Giuliani?
Oh, we're trying to listen here. Can you
back? You guys trying to listen?
Man,
do you mind if I interrupt?
Yeah, go.
We do mind.
Get.
Okay. Rudolph Giuliani covered up what really happened on 9/11, yeah, didn't he?
Please, before we forcibly.
So you're threatening assault?
Okay. Oh, did I say that?
For conspiracy theories, buddy.
You don't think so?
Yeah, you should find a bigger.
I recognize you.
Do you?
You know Bob Tuscan?
Oh yeah, yeah. He's my good friend.
What's that, ma'am?
Hi, excuse me, sir.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine.
How do you feel about Giuliani?
I'm listen.
Yeah. Be gone, dude. Fine. Be gone.
What's that? Is he talking right now? Who is that talking right now? Is that the same guy who covered up 9/11?
Could I get past you? Thank you.
Yes, yes.
Hey, man, I know a company that's hiring, you know, if you want to get a job on a...
You know, last time I spoke with Giuliani, he told me the same thing, to get a job.
Yeah, that's good.
He also told me to get a haircut. I got one.
Yeah, well, you should still go for the job, too.
You think so?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, let's see here. Giuliani came on. What's that? Who? This guy?
Interview of an interview, bro.
Okay, right now we're watching an interview take place. Of an interview?
Rich Denmark.
Rich.
That's Rich Denmark. Can I get your name, please?
Savannah Edgins.
Okay, Savannah Edgins. Okay.
Denmark like the country?
Yep.
Evans like the first name, Evan with an S?
No, that would be E-D-G-E-N-S.
Okay, thank you. There you go for the record. Go ahead.
Oh, I'm just a student. I'm a student at UF, and I'm doing a political blog. I'm here at the Trump rally. Didn't get here early enough to actually get in and take pictures of Trump. So hoping to get, you know, the different viewpoints. I've got a Democrat here. I've got some veterans that are supporting Trump. So I'm just hoping for a diverse, eclectic story.
It's great she's interviewing both sides, right?
Yeah, definitely is. I came here to peacefully protest and been already cursed at and yelled at. So keeping most of my views to myself and just continuing my peaceful protest. That way I don't get into any devolved arguments.
Now we have a two-party system, as you know, predominantly, but I'm a big fan of D's in 2016. How do you feel about that?
Democrats in 2016?
No, D's.
Oh. I'm sorry. Can you clarify?
D's nuts,
yeah. D's nuts 2016. Yep. Sounds great.
Okay, there you go. D's nuts 2016, making the platform. Thank you both. We're trying to interrupt an interview of an interview. That was the first thing that we've ever thought to do. Let's interview this gentleman right here. I love the hair, sir. Would you consider that a Jufro, or what would you consider that? All right, Eddie, let's go do something. Wait until you see this, though, dude. The people are priceless. Wow. Regardless of whatever perspectives you have, they are just priceless.
Are you giving them a chance to get real question answers?
Yeah,
or you're not setting them up?
Oh, yeah, I'm setting them up. Yeah, I'm full on setting them up.
Glenn's a rapist.
Can we talk about that for a second?
Hello.
Hi there.
Hi.
Bob Tuscan here with BobTuscan.com. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
Bill Clinton's a rapist?
Yes, he is. He is.
Describe
the rape? No, I wasn't there, but that's what I hear.
Is Bill Clinton really a woman? I've heard some conspiracies about the validity of his gender. Can you speak to that at all?
Well, that would be a hell of a drag queen ensemble. You know, that would be a blockbuster if he was. That really would. I mean, that would make, you know, the Building 7 look like a, you know, like a fairy tale, I think. Yeah.
What happened with Building 7?
I wasn't there. I don't know.
Did you watch the footage?
I watched what was on TV.
Yeah. How could a building like that fall in the fashion that it fell?
I don't know. Maybe there were some people on the inside that were lighting up, you know, had charges or, you know, plastic explosives or something.
Is it possible Bill Clinton raped the crew that was behind the collapse of Building 7?
The whole crew?
Yeah, yeah.
I'd have to see the video.
And when I talk about rape, I mean predominantly butt sex.
Butt sex in Building 7. That's got a ring to it. I like it, yeah.
So Trump could win on the platform that Bill Clinton raped the people that blew up Building 7.
I think that should be part of the platform. Butt sex in Building 7, we're not going to take it anymore.
Trump 2016, ladies and gentlemen, this is something we can really get behind. I want to thank you.
You bet, anytime.
All righty. And thank you too, Virginia. We got all the crazies together now in one spot, and when I say crazy, I mean they're crazy.
See
if we can jump in here.
Because he was telling the truth. Robert Lavoie Finicum, wearing one of these, an American rancher, was gunned down in a snowbank by 9 long guns. FBI murdered for telling the truth about yellow cake uranium and the Clinton Foundation stealing it to sell it to the Russians, to Putin. You see, Hillary is in with Putin. Hillary is tied up with Putin, not Trump. Sons of Liberty, National Council right here, Jack Powers. My man, Robert Lavoie Finicum in Oregon, was murdered by the FBI. He had his hands up. No weapons. He was wearing one of these, and they gunned him down in a snowbank.
Okay, you're talking about a case. How many times has that happened? How many times has that happened?
Many white murders have gone unannounced.
How many times has that happened?
Murders have.
How many times has that happened?
How many times?
Yeah, how many times has that
happened? You'd be surprised because you don't hear about it on the news.
How many times that has happened?
You would be surprised.
But when you're living it, though.
I live it. When you're living it. I live it now.
When you're living it.
I go back and forth to D.C., do you?
Make it stop. Make it stop, please.
Several times. Folks, Building 7 is something that we ought to pay attention to. This right here, folks, is what it's all about. These two gentlemen are behind the revolution to keep us in a bipartisan, never-ending loop. It's Groundhog's Day, ladies and gentlemen, and this is Bob Tuscan reporting live from what is essentially a nightmare. If I was to tell you what kind of a world I saw in my future when I was a young child.
Here's what Black Lives, when it started, it wasn't started to create havoc and all this. It was just starting. So when a riot takes
place. But George
place,
Soros is funding them.
Okay, let me finish.
But George Soros is funding them.
Money has a voice, right?
George Soros
money,
is a Nazi.
Money
George
has a
Soros
voice, right?
Is funding Hillary.
You're still missing it.
No, I'm
money
not.
Has a voice,
I don't
right?
miss a thing.
You gonna let me make a comment or what?
Sure, absolutely.
Okay, make
your comment.
Black Lives wasn't started to insinuate riots or anything of that nature. It was just to shed light on the injustice. That's it. Now, if you look at the bylaws, let me finish.
Where were you?
Let me finish.
You just made a comment. Where were you in the Deep South? Where were you in the Deep South?
I was
when
born.
Black men,
I was
when
born.
Black men.
Were the go team. Yeah.
I was born.
Yeah.
Georgia in the South.
Let me finish. Okay. On my grandmother's. On my grandmother's
infested.
Farm. Are they going to kiss, ladies and gentlemen? Are they going to kiss?
Where were your parents?
On my grandmother's farm. My grandfather fought in the war.
Black men
when,
were
when
being
when my grandfather
infested.
Came back from Vietnam, you know what he was called?
I can imagine.
No, you can't imagine.
Yes, I can because
no,
my brother was called the
know
same
what he's
thing.
Called? Your brother was called a nigger?
My brother
right,
was called the
finish.
Same thing.
When my grandfather came, my
a devil.
My grandfather fought in World War II. My
is this
father,
your stage
my father,
mind?
Which
my
war was that, by the way?
In Vietnam.
Is this your stage
I don't know
of mind?
If that was Korean War or one
is
of those
this
wars.
Your stage
but
of mind?
My daddy fought in
which
Vietnam.
Which stage
war.
Is this? Yours or mine?
It's our stage.
Okay.
So now.
So we get equal
my dad,
time?
My daddy fought in the Vietnam War.
Do I get 2 minutes?
You know when he came home? Oh, this is like the debate. You get 2 minutes.
Well, dude, you're
I gotta tell you. You are the master, and you are the master as well. You both are the master debaters.
Let's do 2 minutes.
Or masturbators.
Yeah.
Or masturbators.
Oh, I beg to...
That was very crude.
It's in the news today. Look at Anthony Weiner.
Why are you screaming?
Let's not get somebody's wiener in the middle of this, okay?
I got the mouth.
Why are we looking at Anthony's wiener? Can somebody tell me why we're looking at Anthony's wiener?
So what is liberty to you?
Why?
What is liberty?
Why?
Was he circumcised?
What is liberty to you, man?
Stay the hell out of my business if you're the government.
What is liberty to you, man?
Small government and arms.
What about no government?
To you?
Small government and arms.
What is liberty to you?
Small government.
What is liberty to you?
I'm telling you, small government and arms.
What is liberty to you? What is it to you?
Second Amendment.
What is it to you?
The United States Constitution.
What is it to you?
It's important.
What is it to you? How is it important?
Why don't you get off your...
No, come on, man. How is
it important? You're so full of yourself.
I'm not so full of anything,
You're so full of yourself.
I'm a black man living today.
You're so full of yourself. Hey, why do you
have... I have three black sons.
Can I get a song going?
Why do you...
Kumbaya, my lord. Kumbaya. Come on, everybody. You know the words. Kumbaya, my lord. Kumbaya.
You know who I admire?
This is going nowhere. We love these two. This is like, this is Adam and Steve, ladies and gentlemen.
Because he stands up.
Not Adam and Eve, Adam and Steve.
He's constitutionally elected.
He's a sheriff.
Yes.
He's a sheriff.
Yes.
Do gay biracial marriages matter to you guys? I see that you're a gay biracial couple. Is gay marriage a big thing?
Really? Oh, here's the thing with me.
See,
we're interviewing the first gay biracial couple to get married in America.
Are you starting shit?
And, no, I figured...
Listen to him. This is the media for you.
I know.
Here's the freaking media.
That's exactly what media does.
I know.
You and I just... Hey, you and I just met, but we're not... You and I just...
Whoa, look at that dance move. Look at that. Show us that dance move.
Okay, so check this out.
By the way, he's got better rhythm than you do. How do you feel about that?
I don't feel... I don't like gay marriages.
Don't do that.
Oh, easy, guys. Easy.
I don't like gay marriages.
Don't do what you...
I don't like that.
All right.
I believe in a woman...
It's Adam and Eve, not Adam and Steve, right?
Central Intelligence.
I believe in woman and man.
It's the CIA.
CIA.
No, not at all.
Yeah, he's CIA.
I did this on purpose. I dressed like this on purpose.
That's racist that you think he's CIA.
You think I'm CIA? Why do you think I'm CIA?
It's entirely possible.
Because you're a good-looking black guy in a suit.
So
I've been around the lobby.
All good-looking black guys in a nice suit are either CIA, FBI, NSA, IRS, FBI.
Yep, I remember you. Were you at the war crime?
Here she is. You need to take your money and go home, Hillary. Get out of our party. Get out of our party. Get out. We are nice people. Get out of our party. Why are you here? Why are you here? I'm asking.
I'm here for the Building 7. Let's get on camera.
I'm here for the camera.
I'm here for the Building 7 platform.
Yeah. Okay. So, are you here for the emails? Are you here for Benghazi? Are you here for everything that we're gonna lose with her? That liar.
Just for the record, there is clearly alcohol on her breath. Clearly.
Yes, there is alcohol on my breath.
Just for the record, I'm not anti-alcoholics. How many beers, ma'am? How many beers?
Two.
Two? Only two.
Only two. I'm not carrying anything with me. So talk to people. Let's go, people. Stick up for Trump. Let's go. What has Hillary got to offer you? What has Hillary got to offer you?
Nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing. Raise taxes.
Yeah, raise our taxes. You know what?
Yeah. There we go. Yeah. Does Hillary have a pussy? No. Nothing.
You know why? Because he hasn't seen it because he's raped everybody else.
That's right.
Okay?
Yeah.
You know what? Isn't that good?
Yeah.
He raped her.
Bill Clinton's a rapist.
Yeah.
I was affiliated.
What do you think?
Building 7.
Let's see. He ain't even 20. What do you want?
What's that?
He's not even 20.
20 years.
20 years?
You're not 20 years old, are you?
No, I'm only 15. How do you feel about that?
I figured that, yeah.
Would Bill Clinton rape me at 15 years old? Is that more up his alley?
You don't talk about Bill Clinton.
No. What about Building 7?
How about Building 7 because of you?
How about our people in Benghazi? How about us losing our energy here? How about you guys bringing everybody over here so I have to pay for it? I'm tired of paying. I am hurting for money. I'm tired of paying.
Do you see my shirt, by the way?
Yeah.
Well, taxation, no, I didn't.
Yes.
But you know what? Why are you here for Hillary?
I don't know where you got the idea that I'm here for Hillary.
Do you even pay taxes?
Who are you voting for?
No, I don't. I don't.
This is going to be on the news. Can we please ask Hillary to apologize to the families of the Benghazi victims?
Yes.
You know, they want an apology for everybody else from Trump. I'd like to see.
What happened to Benghazi, ladies and gentlemen?
The victims of the Benghazi.
Listen. And 9/11, Building 7?
For Christmas. He got this for Christmas. And that came in a box.
Sir, how do you feel about being an anti-Semitic response? For the record, I got this for Hanukkah, not Christmas. Hanukkah.
You used to live in your parents' basement?
I do, and I wear a tinfoil hat. I just didn't bring it with me. How do you feel about that?
I feel for you.
Who are you here for?
You should have a good
I'm here for. Hold on 1 second. Say that for the mic, please.
Who are you here for?
I'm here for D's.
What? Are you supporting Trump or Hillary?
I'm supporting neither. I'm going for the third candidate, third party candidate D's.
Where's the camera if that's what Gainesville knows?
I don't know.
My cameraman right here.
This is PVC pipe.
Right.
This is PVC pipe.
Are you interested in D's platform?
I've never even heard of D's. What is that?
Yeah. D's nuts?
You know,
There you go, folks. She's never heard of D's.
Typical liberal talk is what you're doing.
I say we grab them by the nuts.
You're just disgusting.
D's nuts.
Why don't you talk about issues? You sound like a liberal how you're talking.
Okay, let me ask
you. Talk about the issues. Why don't we talk about Benghazi? Why don't we talk about the taxes? Why don't we talk about health care? Yeah. Yeah, you think your taxes are going down, and then you talk about free education? All these younger people think free education? Are you kidding me?
Common Core.
Do you really think that you're going to get free education? When you finish school, you're going to be charged outrageous taxes to pay for the next group to come in for school. There's no such thing as nothing free. Nothing is free.
Where does the money come from? Where's the money come from?
Let's talk about that. The Federal Reserve prints the money out of thin air in a fractional reserve banking system that is absolutely corrupt. How do you feel about the Federal Reserve and the way they practice fractional reserve banking?
I'm sorry, I wasn't even listening to you.
They're corrupt.
Yes, they're corrupt.
Absolutely.
Anyway, so
the Federal Reserve is corrupt?
What do you think about the open borders?
Do you support the Federal Reserve?
No, I'm asking my question. Can I get the mic? All right, thank you. I'm asking, what do you think about ISIS? What do you think about people coming over?
ISIS?
Yes, you can, absolutely.
Okay. We just heard that the Pentagon staged many of these ISIS beheadings. That it was Hollywood fakery. They staged.
It's not Hollywood fakery. It's not.
Wow. They staged it? Yeah. The Pentagon has now come out and said, point blank, they staged the
everything, huh? You think so? So that's like the Dick Cheney thing. Because a lot of stuff was staged by Dick Cheney.
Right. During the Gulf War.
Oh, he created a separate entity within the Pentagon concerning the Iraqi war. That we should have never went over there. Should have went straight at Iran or Afghanistan.
Yeah, because they were behind 9/11, of course.
Oh, so that's what you think, huh? Okay.
Well, actually, no, I don't think that. I'm confused.
You're confused?
Yeah.
What do you mean you're confused?
Well, I don't know if I like boys or girls. I'm confused.
Yeah, you are confused if you don't know that. Yeah, you are.
By the way, let's go back to the biracial gay marriage thing.
Yeah, you said I was hooked up with the cowboy. Really?
That was good, right? That was a good twist.
That was nice, yeah.
That was good.
But I have a beautiful wife who stands with me. But
where
anyway,
is she?
She's not here.
Where is she?
She's a nurse, so you already know.
Hold on. God bless America.
Yes, I am. Very much so.
All right, so I'm very confused here. I have no idea what's going on. This is completely mind-blowing. I am just running around like a chicken with my head cut off. I believe Donald Trump is now entering the building. This is big, folks. This is big. Donald Trump! Yeah! Let's make America Building 7 again. Every time I mention Building 7, I get no response. I'm confused. Who's here today?
What do you think? Donald Trump is here today. Listen, you can hear him. The next president of the United States is here today, and he's speaking right now.
Raise the roof.
That's right. Raise the roof, everybody.
There you go. Next president.
The next president is right there.
Now, the elections are rigged, and Hillary's going to steal it. How do you feel about that?
You know, Hillary, why doesn't she go back to Chelsea's emergency room? That's how I feel about that.
Good one. All right. Oh, okay, sure. How are you? How are you, sir? Do you think this fence is enough to keep out the Mexicans? No? Yeah, man. I see you have a clown shirt on. Do clown lives matter?
Yes, they do.
How do you feel about the discrimination against clowns?
Not all clowns are evil.
Is Donald Trump going to bring clowns back to the prominent place they once were?
The election don't matter to me anyways.
It doesn't?
Nope. I'm just here for this year right here, the entertainment. I can't vote, so it don't matter.
Are you a felon?
Yes, I am.
Congratulations.
You're welcome.
There you go. A felon can't vote. It's here for the entertainment. It's funny. Our felons know more about what's going on than most people do. Felons 2016, because both of them actually are felons now that I think about it. Kind of works. Yep. So let me get this straight, though. You're a felon. You can't vote, but both candidates are felons.
Yeah, I guess so.
Don't you think that's a little bit biased that felons can't vote for felons?
Exactly. But I wouldn't care anyways, so.
All right. Well, folks, felons should be able to vote for felons. That's an absolute outrage that they can't.
Thank you.
There you go. Who is that stalking right now? Is that him? Can't believe I'm close enough to hear his voice. Donald Trump is excuse me, speaking right now. I think his talks are getting better than ever before, and cocaine, yeah. How do you feel about there being no garbage cans at this event?
I don't know. I don't really got a feeling, but I don't like it on my table.
That's your table?
Yeah.
So, ladies and gentlemen, that's his table, and that just shows how deplorable the people are at this event. Hi there. I just purchased this bottle of water from you guys, and I was just curious. Is this water fluoridated?
It comes from the bottle. It says Blue Mountain Springs, so I would say no.
Not fluoridated. Great.
Spring water.
I'm sorry?
Spring water. Good. So there you go, folks. Trump water is not fluoridated. That's good to know. What's that?
I said you're an idiot.
Thank you so much. There you go. I'm an idiot. Why? Because I asked if the water was fluoridated. It's good to know. I'm an idiot. What's that?
What's that? What's the? Oh,
I'm Bob Tuscan.
Okay, Mauricio Dugay.
Yeah. So I like your shirt. Positive thoughts lead to positive actions.
Oh, absolutely. That's what we need today, man.
How about this for a 2016 platform? Fuck politics. Grow a garden. Love your family. And do right by one another.
I agree with that too.
There you go. I'm voting for this guy.
Absolutely. I agree with that, man.
Why are you here? Are you enjoying the circus or what's the deal?
Well, I'm an artist. I just walk around and show my work, you know.
You're an artist.
I'm an artist, yeah.
Let's see what you got here.
I'm a micro sculpture, buddy.
Pretty cool. It's called Chalk Show.
Chalk sculptures, yeah. I'm a micro sculpture.
Microsculpture. So you sculpt small little things.
Absolutely.
Are you familiar with the fact that Donald Trump has a micro penis?
Oh yeah.
Sorry, I couldn't resist.
Dixies.
Oh, look at this. And is this an actual replica of Donald's penis? Is that actually Donald's penis? No. I want to go back to the phallic looking one. Is that Donald?
Yeah.
That's little Abe.
Hey,
tall hat, small penis.
Dr. King.
Oh, that one. I can't make a joke about that one.
That's awesome, man. That's what I do, man. I just do my work, man. I do my hardware. That's it.
I love it.
Are you from Gainesville, right?
Yeah, yeah. By the way, I'm very autistic.
Really? What kind of work you do?
All sorts of things. I like to make Mandelas.
Mandela.
Yeah.
Oh, Nelson Mandela.
Yeah.
Nelson. As a matter of fact, I'm working in him right now.
Are you really?
Oh, yeah.
What synchronicity?
I'm working in Mandela. As a matter of fact, tomorrow I'll do Bob Marley and put him in.
Big head, small head?
Small heads, man.
Small heads.
Yeah, I'll do them all, man. I'm trying to be part of that show in Gainesville.
You know, they say black guys usually have big heads.
Well, I don't know about that.
No, no.
I know what I have.
That's good, man. All right, buddy. Take care. Positive thoughts lead to positive actions. I like it a lot. All right, let's continue. There's a lot of entrepreneurs here selling Trump merchandise. Do they support Trump? Highly doubtful. But they do support making money. That's awesome. This is great. Puppies for Trump.
Puppy for Trump.
Aww.
Look at his fake
mic. There you go. Is he old enough to vote?
I hope so.
Okay, cool.
He could vote for Hillary because, look, I mean, she would put the dog's name to vote for Hillary because she's doing the voter fraud.
Well, it's a boy dog, not a bitch. Can I just interview you about this tattoo? The hottest place in hell is reserved for those who remain neutral in times of great moral conflict. Do you really feel that's the case?
Yes, I do.
How do you feel about the fact that most people still, 15 years later, have said nothing about what really happened on 9/11?
Why are you talking about that? That's the only thing that you're talking about is 9/11 and whatever else, and you don't even know what the hell you're saying. And your fake microphone, and this is fraud. This is fraud. Stop grabbing it. Why? Why?
Because I don't like to be grabbed in the pussy.
Oh my God, see, you're so immature.
Listen, when you talk to him, you lower the IQ here.
Oh, no, he lowers the IQ. That's
why is that, sir?
By you talking to him.
All right.
Thank you. Take care. She kept grabbing my mic, and, you know, I guess that really speaks to the fact that supporters of Donald, I guess, grab people by the mic. Let's interview this gentleman right here. Sir, I noticed you had a Donald Trump sign in your front yard before a lot of other people. How do you feel about that?
Have I met you somewhere?
We're here today asking people about the Donald Trump Building 7 platform. How do you feel about that?
I hadn't really delved into that particular aspect. There's so much going on. It's really kind of crazy.
Are you familiar with Trump's...
Am I famous?
Yeah, are you familiar with Trump's stance on Building 7?
I'm not, actually. Curiously, I'm not.
Well, Donald, I believe, was quoted in saying that he likes his women. This is just locker room talk. Like, he likes Building 7 going down on him in free fall speed. That was a paraphrase, maybe, but something along there.
Well, it was a turn of phrase. It was a turn of phrase. You should write, actually. You know.
I should.
You should, yeah. No, I mean like novel-length stuff. With phrases like that, I mean, you should work it. Really should.
Lastly, do you plan on grabbing anybody by the pussy today?
I think it's not on my calendar for today. Catch me tomorrow. I might have a different answer.
Great. There you go, folks. Trump fans not planning today to grab somebody by the pussy, but maybe on a different calendar day. We shall see. Wayne, good to see you, boss.
Thanks,
man. All right, so what's your interest today in filming me? Anything in particular?
Coming out and see what's going on. Get some live footage of the event.
Yeah, and I caught your attention.
Yes.
Why is that?
I like your shirt.
Cool.
Yeah, Let's see what you guys are...
Taxation is theft.
So far, I've noticed, I think, 3 or 4, I don't even want to call them protesters, but... people who aren't here probably to support Trump, so.
I'm not here, I'm not supporting Trump.
Yeah, I figured as much, I heard you talking to them, but.
Yeah,
I didn't
but know I'm not supporting Hillary.
Yeah, I can understand.
I'm not supporting Gary Johnson.
Yeah, I'm not either.
I'm not supporting Jill Stein.
Okay.
I am supporting Deez.
What's that? Deez Nuts?
Yeah, Deez Nuts.
Okay, yeah.
Finally a guy who gets it.
I've heard he's polling pretty high in some places.
Yeah, you know, I really hope that he's on the ballot. If he's not, I might flop him in.
Yeah, right, makes sense. In the debates. Whip him out for the debates.
Well, just in that private booth.
Right, no doubt.
I mean, the only other time I whip out Deez Nuts is at the airport when the TSA gropes me.
Right.
That's not a mic, you know, that ain't nothing.
What is it?
It's a piece of plastic.
It is.
I know, that's yeah,
awesome.
It is. So
it is. Just practice. It's a piece of plastic.
I got my mic.
You do? Let's interview each other.
Voting for Trump.
Who?
Trump.
Who?
Trump.
Trump. Yeah. By the way, hey, give me a call sometime.
What's up?
Give me a call sometime.
Sure.
My wife would be happy about it.
What about 1-800-NEVER?
All right, sounds good. This is a great place to pick up women.
Signing a legal cannabis petition, would you?
I'm sorry, what is it for?
This is for legal cannabis. This is following behind the Medical Marijuana Amendment 2. This is so that anyone over the age of 21 in the state of Florida will be able to possess, use, and grow it on their own personal property and use it not in public. This is for personal use in private.
Should the war on drugs altogether be abolished?
Well, the war on drugs could imply a lot of things. The war on cannabis... Absolutely. Look how many.
So heroin's okay to send armed thugs after essentially people who are sick?
I didn't say that. Heroin needs to be dealt with a little bit differently. It's an addictive, dangerous drug that can kill people. Marijuana or cannabis, which is the proper name of it, does not.
There you go. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thanks for calling.
Donald, you're probably the best known builder, particularly of great buildings in the city. There's a great deal of question about whether or not the damage and the ultimate destruction of the buildings was caused by the airplanes, by architectural defect, or possibly by bombs or aftershocks. Do you have any thoughts on that?
Well, it was an architectural defect. You know, the World Trade Center was always known as a very, very strong building. Don't forget, that took a big bomb in the basement. Now, the basement is the most vulnerable place because it's your foundation, and it withstood that. And I got to see that area about 3 or 4 days after it took place because one of my structural engineers actually took me for a tour because he did the building. And I said, I can't believe it. The building was standing solid, and half of the columns were blown out. I mean, so this was an unbelievably powerful building. If you know anything about structure, it was one of the first buildings that was built from the outside. The steel, the reason the World Trade Center had such narrow windows is that in between all the windows, you had the steel on the outside. So you had the steel on the outside of the building. That's why when I first looked, and you had big, heavy I-beams, when I first looked at it, I couldn't believe it because there was a hole in the steel. And this is steel that was, you remember the width of the windows in the World Trade Center, folks. I think, you know, if you were ever up there, they were quite narrow. And in between was this heavy steel. I said, how could a plane, even a 767 or 747 or whatever it might have been, how could it possibly go through the steel? I happen to think that they had not only a plane, but they had bombs that exploded almost simultaneously, because I just can't imagine anything being able to go through that wall. Most buildings are built with the steel is on the inside around the elevator shaft. This one was built from the outside, which is the strongest structure you can have, and it was almost just like a can of soup.
You know, Donald, we were looking at pictures all morning long of that plane coming into building number two, and when you see that approach the far side, and then all of a sudden, within a matter of a millisecond, the explosion pops out the other side.
Right. I just think that there was a plane with more than just fuel. I think, obviously, there were very big planes. They were going very rapidly because I was also watching where the plane seemed to be not only going fast, it seemed to be coming down into the building. So it was getting the speed from going downhill, so to speak. It just seemed to me that to do that kind of destruction is even more than a big plane, because you're talking about taking out steel, the heaviest caliber steel that was used on a building. And these buildings were rock solid. And, you know, it's just an amazing thing. This country is different today, and it's going to be different than it ever was for many years to come.
Very profound statement, and very true.